Is it for His glory or for yours? One of the questions I seem to be asking myself these days, are people doing things for His glory or for their own? Each church has a leader, their pastor, who is to shepherd his flock, to train them to share the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ with others, but also to help them grow to spiritual maturity. The spotlight is not to be on the pastor. It's supposed to be on God Almighty and the Lord Jesus Christ. We are to be heard and not seen. In other words, people should see the light of Jesus Christ through us. Unfortunately, these days, a select few pastors seem to be uplifting themselves above their congregations, with palaces, cars, even planes. Yes, I know, this isn't limited to our pastors. Jesus didn't even have his own house. The Lord Jesus walked from town to town, neighborhood to neighborhood, house to house even. Question, were there other means of transportation Christ could have taken advantage of other than bipedal locomotion? Of course, Jesus could have ridden camels or donkeys to get around. Yes, Jesus Christ did use a boat to get across water, but no, he didn't always walk across the waters. Jesus used the boats readily available, fishing boats, not fancy yachts. We, all believers, are Jesus Christ's light upon the world. Our primary goal in this life is to share the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are to share the truth and encourage people to read God's Word, the Holy Bible. Encourage people to accept God's amazing saving grace through His free gift of salvation. To share that redemption comes from the crucifixion through the resurrection. Most importantly, we can each be in God Almighty's immediate presence with the Lord Jesus Christ for eternity if we accept God's free gift of salvation. When we share our testimony with others, humility must be a priority. God Almighty, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, we uplift them for all God does for us and for all God does through us. We must make it clear that what we share is for them, through them, by them, when we are shining Jesus' light. God's love, God's mercy, and God's saving grace is what others must see through us. Remember Jesus Christ's parting command, love one another. Also, Proverbs 10:12 states, hatred stirs up strife, but love covers all sins. My prayer for you is that you will always, when shining Jesus' light, do it for God Almighty's glory. Amen.